The expression of political opinion on university campuses all over the world is nothing new. But some of the sentiment that's being expressed today is getting a little bit concerning.
We support the Antifa!
We support the Antifa!
Israel is a terrorist state!
I would have never said a year ago that this would happen on my campus. 30-something percent Jews, proud Jews, Zionists, such strong Jewish and Israel community, pro-Israel communities. This would never happen. It happened. People were being, you know, verbally, maliciously attacked for saying, I believe in the right to a state of Israel. The anti-Israel sentiment has only escalated. The campus is going to become more and more polarized.
It's been more hostile a feel on campus, which didn't used to be the case.
I never thought that any anti-Israel activity would happen on this campus.
I've been at university campuses discussing and dealing with this issue, and I've seen the very difficult situation that Jewish students face.
This week at the University of Sydney, the Colonel Richard Kemp was giving a lecture on the ethics of military tactics, when he was rather aggressively interrupted. I have no problem with students expressing their freedom of speech, their democratic right to do so, in this case suggesting that Colonel Kemp is somehow supporting genocide in his support for the State of Israel. However, I do have a problem with what followed. So Jake Lynch, Professor Jake Lynch, a faculty member, perhaps in the audience to listen to the Colonel's talk for some academic reason, presumably decided to take it on himself to join in the fracas, possibly to try and defuse the situation. But he's ended up waving a $5 note under the nose of an elderly Jewish lady who was there, enraged by the anti-Israeli feeling that was in the university. My children will be preparing to go to university soon, and I'm hoping that they'll have the protection of the faculty against some of the more aggressive elements in the democratic student population. But I'm afraid there are some, even amongst our own Jewish community, whose feelings, particularly against Israel, are inviting anti-Semitism of an awful high degree.
I stand here today as a part of the International Jewish Anti-Zionist Network.
See, to me, to be Jewish and anti-Zionist is a bit of a sort of an oxymoron. I appreciate there are many Jews that feel that way, but it just doesn't work.
We also call on Jewish people everywhere to recognize in this most recent bout of Israeli terror a larger and unmistakable pattern of unbridled violence and murder, collective punishment, and race hatred.
Murder, violence, race hatred. This is about Israel, of course. This isn't about Jews. But frankly, I'm getting more and more of an anti-Semitic feeling here about what she's saying and the way she's saying it.
In supporting Palestinian self-determination, we act in the Jewish tradition that has fought collective punishment, murder, and racism for centuries. From the river to the sea, Palestine will be free.
Israel is occupying the Palestinian people in my name, in the name of world Jewry, and I myself, an American Jew, am here to say that that is completely unjustified and ethically reprehensible. And we will, world Jewry and all people of the world, will not stop until this occupation ends and until the Palestinian people have their right of return, their right to live without occupation, and equal rights within Israel.
Young Jewish man entitled to his opinion, and we're protecting that right up to a point. I think you'll find that where you see this gentleman going wrong is he doesn't respect the streets in which he's standing, because that is the state of Israel. And whilst he has entitled to speak, he's not entitled to disobey.
My passport. I will not give you my passport. I'm not giving you my passport. I mean, I have a right to be here. I have a right to be here. Don't push me. Do I need to call my... I'm going to call my counselor right now. Get off me. Do I need to call my counselor right now?
Around a third of the Syrian Kurdish fighting force is made up of women. Many of them are still teenagers. They fight alongside the men, facing the same enemy and the same dangers. Diren is just 19 years old.
When they see a woman with a gun, they're so afraid they begin to shake. They portray themselves as tough guys to the world. They see women as just little things, but one of our women is worth 100 of them.
Whatever happened to the peace now, the love not war approach that when I was younger, that was far more attractive than the avenues of war. Something rather awful, I think, is happening here.
The baby face of an Islamic State recruit. This is Jake Belardi, the latest Australian revealed to be fighting in Iraq and Syria. Known as a bright student, but a troubled loner, he dropped out of his Melbourne school last year and disappeared.
Jake Belardi, an Australian teenager, and a self-radicalised terrorist. Sounds extraordinary, but then, using the internet as the tool, Islamic State have been able to influence without directly contacting this individual. And many terrorist organisations will be learning from that. The rise of anti-Semitism and anti-Zionism gives more opportunity for more teenagers to be self-radicalised. We need to do something.
It's really about providing young people with alternatives, allowing young people to become part of the solution, not just framing them as part of the problem, not just always putting them under the microscope and saying, you know, you guys are the issue because you're constantly being radicalized and you're a threat to public safety and national security. These guys have the answers, you know. Forget academics. Forget me, forget my generation, forget all the theories that you read in books. These kids have the answers because youth have the answers for youth.